Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how you can clean up your contacts database by exporting contacts that you may no longer need. So in your Contacts app, you have all of your contacts. And every once in a while, you may want to go through them and clean them out. After all, with iCloud now, these are synced across all of our different devices, which means a long list can be a little cumbersome if you're searching for somebody. So to clean them out, all you need to do, of course, is select one and then hit delete, and it will delete that contact. But if you're like me, sometimes you want to kind of create an archive of old contacts, contacts you don't think you'll ever need again, but it's worth taking just a little bit of space on your Mac's hard drive to have a copy just in case. In order to create a copy of something like that, it's very easy. All you need to do is select it and drag to a Finder window or the desktop, and it creates a simple file for that contact. So now that I've exported this, I can, with it still selected here in Contacts, delete it. And it's gone from my Contacts database, but I still have this file here. So what happens with this file? Well, I could put them in a folder somewhere called Old Contacts, and chances are I might never need them again. But if I do, how can I get access to them? Well, if you have a VCF file, that's what these are called, that's just a single contact, you can actually select it and using Spotlight, just hitting the space bar here, I can actually see the information inside that contact. So I don't need to actually import it back into my Contacts app. I don't need to do anything with it or open it with anything special. I can view the information very easily using Spotlight. Now, if I do want to bring this back into Contacts, I can very easily just drag and drop it into the list here. I can drag and drop it into specific set here. And yeah, I'm going to add that card, and now it's added back, and I can get rid of this like that. Now, say I want to do this for several. It would be great if I could select several different names there and drag and drop, and it will create three different VCF files. But it doesn't. It creates a combined VCF file, and if I try to view that in Spotlight, unfortunately, I don't get the contact information. Now, since this is mostly plain text, I can open it by dragging and dropping it onto TextEdit. And you can see the information is basically there. So I still have a way to get to it. But I find it's probably better to individually drag and drop these contacts. So, you know, drag this one and this one and this one. It doesn't take too much time. And then you can kind of go through your contacts, figure out which ones you want to save, and then delete them, and then have these individual files here. You do have other things that you could do as well. For instance, you can select a contact and you could decide to export as a PDF, and that creates this little PDF file. I'll save it here to the desktop, and you can see I can look at that in Spotlight. You can see it's like a little document. The cool thing about the export to PDF is you can actually do it very easily for multiples. So you can do these here and export as PDF. So it's another way to save out the information. Doing it with the VCF file with the simple drag and drop has the advantage that you can easily bring that contact back into your Contacts app. Now back in episode 830 I showed you how you can actually bring these contacts into Numbers, and that technique still works in Mavericks and in Yosemite. You just open up in Numbers a new document, delete the table that's there, so it's just a completely blank sheet. You can select all or just some of the contacts, drag and drop them into Numbers, and it creates a new table with all the information there. So you have that option there as well. Now you also have the option to export your entire contacts list. Go to Export and Contacts Archive, and it'll create this one file here. But it's difficult to use this file for anything. For instance, you can't drag or drop it back in here. If you double click on it, it will simply ask if you want to replace all your contacts with this database here. So this is more for kind of an emergency backup type of thing than actually saving out some data that you may want to access later.